Hey boys, hey girls. Welcome to Louisiana Cajun Cooking. We survived the spring fling. Man, my dishwasher sure did take a beating. I bet I had to wash about 8 loads. They had them big bread plastic, you know, crawfish things that gotta go in there. But it survived. We're gonna go ahead and make us some crawfish bisque. My most favorite meal in the world. And thanks to the crawfish tail queen, Booger Girl, her husband Tom, and Mike out of Lafayette, they peeled me a nice size bag. I'll weigh it and see how much they peeled. But we had more crawfish than we could eat. And I was busy running around like a chicken without with his head cut off. Trying to, you know, just make sure everybody was happy and having a good time. And they did. I sure did. And we go ahead and make this dish. Thanks to everybody that came again. It was a blast. Great, great bunch of people. We're going to have to do it again next year. Long as they still got crawfish on the earth. And the earth is still here, huh? Cool. All right. First, you got to make a roux. If you can't make a roux, you SOL. That's all I can tell you. I done showed y'all so many times. I'm going to do it in a nuke, too. Because it's easiest. It's the easiest way to do it. Hell yeah. Let me mention something. If you're going to use butter in a roux, I recommend you don't use all butter. Cut it at least in half, if not even use less butter than half with the oil. Be better to use clarified butter or ghee. Ghee is what it's called. It's a culinary term. Google it. You can clarify your own butter. You can also buy ghee already. Butter that's been clarified. Because there's some water in butter that you need to get rid of. You don't want water in a roux right off because that's going to mess it up. That's why you can't use margarine to make a roux. It's got too much water in it. And it will not. It's a fail. It's a don't do. If you try it, you're going to come up with what looks like coarse sand. It's not going to be a smooth, velvety roux. How about that? Now, I believe Russ over at Smoky Ribs was asking where was that table where this photo was taken. Let's go on through the kitchen and into the front room. Here it is here, Russ. I guess you may have missed it this year or forgot about it anyway. And there's the little Charlie Brown Christmas peoples and stuff over there. Cool, huh? That's it there. And it was just a lucky shot with this overhead light shining down, reflecting off my glasses. It was just a lucky shot, dude. I tried to duplicate it and couldn't. The head was just right. Anyway, yeah. So to make clarified butter, melt you some butter, okay? Put it in the refrigerator. And you're going to scoop off the solids off the top and leave just the oil that's at the bottom. To see all that foam? That's butter fat. And this is really not that much. This is only a half a stick. But you'd want to get that foam off the top. So if you're going to make your own clarified butter or ghee, you need to use like a whole pound of butter and do it. And you're going to have a thick layer of foam on top. Put it in the refrigerator, let it cool. Scrape that off and eat it on ice cream. Don't throw it away, boy. That's the good shit. It's going to leave you with just the oil from the butter, which has a very high smoking temperature, higher than olive oil. How about that? Did you know that, boys and girls? I did. Talk about make fried stuff taste good. like fried fish or something like that, or say skinless fish that cooks.
Never mind.
Shrimps, anything. Saute it in it. Yum! Oh man, that's the bomb. It's done in restaurants all the time. Ask the chefs out there, they'll tell you. Peachy sweet. Can I put, it was a half a stick of butter in there. 1 cup, a whole 1 cup of flour. Not packed. I'll pack it. Now we need, let's see, half a stick of butter is, I better go look at a stick because I can't remember how many cups it is. I think it's a quarter cup though. Pretty sure I'm betting it is. Yep, I was right. Quarter cup, half a stick of butter, 4 tablespoons. Look down here, Cammy. Swing around this way, darling. Right there. So we need 1 whole cup of oil total, including that quarter cup of butter. So here's a half cup measurer that I measured the flour with, and we're gonna put another, gonna fill it up halfway this time. It's not all that precise measurement needed. I'm gonna go ahead and stir it and make sure it's gonna liquefy. It's gonna thicken up immensely later on. So I've got a quarter cup of butter and 3/4 cups of oil and 1 cup of flour. Yeah, see that's looking fine. Kind of like a thin peanut butter consistency. Get all the lumps out of him and incorporate the flour well. Then we're going to go put it in the nuke for 5 minutes on high. Get the hell after it. Hurry up and cook. Ooh, loose arm on Cammy on tripod. 5 minutes, don't touch it. Leave it alone. After 5 minutes, we're going to stir it. Look at it, and it's going to change color. It's going to be darker than this. See, right now it's all kind of blonde looking. It's going to get darker. Put it back on for 1 minute on high. Stir it again. So the more flour you do, so let's say if this was 2 cups in here, you'd have to do it longer. But you still start out 5 minutes, stir. 1 minute, stir. 1 minute, stir. 1 minute, stir. Till it gets to the brownness that you want. A couple people asked me, I made a gravy and it tastes like flour because you didn't cook the flour like what I'm doing. So could you make a gravy from a roux? Yeah, it's the same thing. Sure it is. Cook the flour and it gets ridder. It gets rid of the gravy taste, yeah. It get rid of it forever. No, it get rid of the flour taste. It'll give it a toasty. When you cook the flour like this, making a roux, it takes on a nutty flavor, and it's the difference of like eating a raw biscuit and a cooked biscuit. Which one gonna taste better, do you think? Rocket science. I'm telling y'all, that's all it is. Nuclear rocket science. Simple. I'm gonna get another pop. Yeah, I'm loving the rolling tripod. See, we can dance. Come on, dance with me, Cammy. And YouTubers. Oh, hold the dough for JB. Hold me in my dough. Oh, my dough. Are we being silly? Yes, we are. That's enough silliness. We'll have no silliness on this show. Bull. Gonna have fun while we cook. All right, boys, so this is how it looks when you come out. See in there? It's cooled down, actually. Otherwise, I wouldn't be able to hold it. So I'm going to go warm it back up and put some Trinity in here. Right over there. I hope you recording, you stupid ass camera. That button, in one video, that button probably gets the start, stop, recording button must get pressed 50 times in one video. So, yeah, you recording, that's a good thing. I can get my pointed stick and give you a thrashing if you wouldn't. Okay. Well, let's get this heated up and get some Trinity in there. Cut! Okay, our roux is back up to 350. Gotta quickly get some Trinity in there to cool it off. Gonna let this sweat down a bit and also get some garlic in there. Now if you made this on a stove and you were stirring constantly, you don't have to stir as constantly anymore. But I've done it in the nuke. You only have to stir it two or three times. How about that? Now, get that back up to heat, because that was frozen Trinity and it cooled that pot down a lot. Come up to heat. It's going to start releasing liquid. It's going to start getting thick. And by the way, that one cup of flour is enough to thicken up about 6 cups of stock, liquid, whatever you got, like poppy tot. Also add some green onion bottoms in here. And let them get happy. I don't put this on high. Turn the heat down some. Put some garlic in here. Boy, it's just skeet out of that. See that? I sure do like Miss JB's garlic breath. I ain't even feel it. I had to help it skeet that time. See that? Take the peeling off of it, the wrapper. Now we got some garlics in there. Lick your finger where you touch the garlic press. Jump! Stir. It ain't burned, it's starting to stick. Well, I told you, can't stop. You just don't gotta go as often. Now, I want you all happy with yourself and you let this sweat down for, I don't know, about five, 6 minutes. Go ahead and put your seafood stock in there. Cold seafood stock. Don't put no hot stock in here. Unless you're trying to make dumplings with Trinity in them. Scrape everything off the bottom so it don't stick. We're going to let this cook down for a little while. Probably about an hour. We may have to add some more stock. Or just instant diet water. It don't matter. While we add it, come here. Let's start a little bit of seasoning too. And put some pepper in there. Just black pepper. Well, don't hit that case too hard, JB. It might explode. Anti-terrorist kit. And some salt. Yeah. Gently. Salts, okay. We don't put our crawfish in here yet, no boy. We'll let this cook down. It's gonna thicken up. This is one of my very, very favorite dish in the world. I think I already told you that by. All right, I got some homemade Trinity right here, fresh. And I got some butter. And I'm gonna go ahead and, it's the other half a stick of butter. I'm gonna saute this down in that butter. Let me go warm this damn pot up. See, butter, pot, Trinity down there. And then we're gonna make a dressing or a breading or stuffing with crawfish meat. Yum. Got us some butter. Got us some Trinity. We're gonna let this sweat down a little bit with a lot of salt. See it? It looked like snow. And some black pepper. Get some garlic in there too. That much. I'm gonna squeeze it in. Squeeze it in with the garlic press. I had to hiccup, I'm sorry. Well, I dumped in some scallions into this with the garlic and about a teaspoon of flour. This is a little bit of thickener. A tablespoon of flour. We're gonna let this cool off. Then we're gonna puree this in the food processor along with some crawfish tails and make some balls. Crawfish balls. Traditionally, this would be this breading, this stuffing mix, would be put in back into the head part of the crawfish that's been cleaned. Pain in the ass to do. Just make balls. That's what old Juice Dan Wilson would do. Just use an ice cream scooper and make you some balls. You can either fry them or bake them and carry on and commence to proceed, boy. Like fried boudin balls, huh? Yep, exactly. Yum. So I got about 3 pounds, or really 2.5 pounds, of peeled crawfish tail meat from the boil that we had. That Booger, Tom, and Mike peeled for us. And that's them in there. See? And they're frozen. So we got to defrost them. And I'm going to do that by simply running some water over them. I'll put some water in the bag. Now, let them defrost. We'll be able to use them because we need half over that and half over that. You'll see. All right, so I got some old stale bread here. Just hamburger buns. And we're going to put them into the food processor. And spill them all over the place. Get in there, boy. No escapees required or needed. And as that sauteed down stuff, it's going in there too. And it's going to be for the balls, the stuffing. Seeing that? So one cackle fruit, fresh, out of a chicken's butt, going in there like that. And these are from my daughter Brandy, and they raised chickens. Yum.
Cool, huh?
Now let's get us some of this thawed out crawfish tail meat. Look over this way, boy. See right down here? It's mostly thawed. See, busting up. And it's got liquids in it. It's still partially frozen. That's all right. Mr. Food Processor going to take care of that. We're going to have us a stuffing. We're going to have to worry this a little bit. I can see that coming. Y'all get on down in there. You want to make a nice little batter with this. See how this is coming along like that there? I like kicking that tripod just around like that. Man, that works good, Thomas. Now, we got us a batter we can form into balls. See, like that? Make little balls out of them. Yum. Check it for salt. Don't worry about the raw egg. Just eat the son of a bitch. And taste it. Make sure it's going to be okay. All right? Good. Putting another handful of tail meat in there. So that's probably a good pound at this point. You can't turn it on with the top off. Oh, otherwise it'd go boom and be up on the ceiling, and you don't want that. So put the top on, boy. And check your crawfish, because this is from the ball. For salt, it rock. So now let's dismount. And start scooping this out. Meatballs, that is, boy. I sprayed a cookie sheet down with some Pam. Yeah. Pam's happy on the sheet. And fitting to get laid down with some of this, these little balls. Okay. We're gonna have to form them better than this. I need to get me a damn, how you call it? One of them ice cream scoopers to form these up with. I'll just use my hands right there. But I won't be careful. And down inside of there is them cutting blades. I don't want to get cut. So, let's make us some balls, and then we can reform them. Shut up, phone! With our hands. Oh, son of a bitch. I had another thought. I just decided, I've seen Juice Dan Wilson do this one time also. He greased a loaf pan and used the stuffing to make a little meatloaf. And that way, you can take it and slice it And everybody gets some. We're going to go bake this off in the oven until it's cooked all the way through. Remember, it's got some raw egg in there, some other raw vegetables that need to warm through. The crawfish already cooked. And now they're all, it's a pate. Oh, it's a fancy French word. Cool. Now we're going to take about another pound of crawfish tail meat and pour it in here. And this is, you could call this a stew. But now we're going to have a stew with bisque-like meatloaf. I like that. That's a new word. Crawfish meatloaf stew. Now, how you want to act? Yum. Okay, so here we got that crawfish meatloaf. Let's see it again. Out the oven. And Miss JB is getting some of the stew. We got some rice.
Got the rice.
And she's gonna cut some of the meatloaf. And get her a piece. And this is just crawfish stuffing. Get a spoon and dig it out. Whatever spoon you're gonna eat with. Put your hand up at me like that.
Boy.
Where the camera? Oh, there you go.
I don't know. You didn't get a grip.
I got my grip on my camera.
Yeah. Get a grip on yourself.
Ooh. We'll give us a little bit of rice. Yum. And some stew right on top. See that? Like that right there. Yum. Now, over here, boy, let's cut some of this crawfish stuffing meatloaf. Hotsy totsy, baby. And put it right on top. Really hot, really hot. Sorry. Yum. 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 See right there? That rocks. Get you some bread and some butter and eat. Oh, just put a little garnish on it. Like that.